See, because that hits that heat, gives a nice flavor. Now, I'm going to add a little beef stock to this. As our beef stock heats up, you're going to see all we did was make gravy. So as soon as I get our gravy adjusted, and this will simmer on a low fire, we can go ahead, since we're getting close, and put our potatoes back in to fry. I don't want to put too much stock in at a time, because I don't want it to get too thin. I want to keep it fairly thick. That's why you see me keep adding a little stock at a time. Come on, baby, get on in. Now, while you're smoothing yourself together, I'm going to go ahead and get those potatoes back in the deep fry. Behave, okay? All right, great. See, by putting our fries back in for the second fry, now we can get them nice and crispy exactly where we want them. Look how quick they're browning off. They're browning off already because they had that moment to cool. So we have to go back and finish our gravy, turn our sausage one more time while these guys cook, because, oh, we're almost there. All right, how you guys doing in here? You good? All right, turn over one more time. Come on, roll over, Beethoven. Roll over. I love the crispiness on that sausage. Now, of course, here, with our gravy, we have to taste it and adjust the seasoning as we need to, because we want it to match up with the potatoes. We want it to go well with the sausage. All right, let's see where you are. Oh, yeah. No more Creole seasoning. No more salt. Also, let's get in the rest of the green onions. Let's get in the rest of the parsley. You look wonderful. We're going to give you another stir. Our fries are good. Let's get our fries out. Look how beautiful those are. And you know, of course, just a little bit of seasoning on them when they first come out. Let's get some fries in. Oh, you just look so good. Come on. Stack up right there. Just like that. Oh, look at it. Now let's grab a couple of pieces of sausage. You can get here. Come on in, join the party. Okay, let's put another one here. Get right there. All right, you good right there?
Ooh, we're gonna get one more. Can you fit? Yes, I can fit.
Oh, look at that. Let's get a little gravy. Just put that right on the top.
How much?
Up to you. We'll put that gravy right on the top of those fries.
Finishing it off.
Got little cheese curds.
And you can find them in the grocery store in the cheese section. I tell you what, they're absolutely delicious.
Oh, baby.
Doesn't that look good? Here's our German sausage with our Cajun poutine. Coming up next, a perfect Oktoberfest test. A traditional German pretzel.
Oh, that's just great.
We have Bratwurst, Bavarian, all the way from Munich.
It's the best of the worst.
This is the best of the worst.
Now getting fancy.
Oh, yeah, you know what I'm saying. It's a German pretzel.
Lagenfenster.
That's close enough. I hope it's close. You know what I mean. We have to get our yeast activated first. So what I have? Warm water. We're going to get our yeast in to get this activated. Now, I'm using a little molasses. A lot of recipes for pretzels call for barley malt syrup, which is very similar to molasses, but the little bit of sweetness that comes from this helps to get this yeast activated. So basically, we're gonna let this sit here, and it should start to bubble for us We'll get the little bubbles along the sides. Here, I have a little water, and I'm gonna put in a little baking soda. This baking soda, I want to stir